Hello friends, welcome to this session. Today we will solve some of the problems on the temperature stresses, as we already clear our concept on the temperature stresses in the previous video lecture. So in the today's session we will take only problems on the temperature stresses. So let us take one problem onto the temperature stress. I will read first of all the problem. Aluminium alloy bar fixed at its end is heated through 20K, means 20 degrees Celsius. Find the stresses developed in the bar. Take E is equal to 210 GPa gigapascal, and alpha is the coefficient of thermal expansion is given, 24 into 10 raised to minus 6 per degree Celsius. Solution. So in this problem, temperature 20 degree Celsius is given, and modulus of elasticity is given, 210 into 10 raised to 3 Newton per mm square or MPa. Coefficient of thermal expansion, that is alpha, is equal to 24 into 10 raised to minus 6 per degree Celsius. So in this problem, they ask about to finding out the stresses developed in the bar. As the temperature is increases, there is an expansion is taken place into the bar. So though in this particular alloy bar, aluminium alloy bar is fixed at its ends, so that's why there is no free movement or free expansion of the bar at its end. So that's why there are temperature stresses are developed. If this bar is free to expand in both the direction, at that time there will not be any development of the temperature stresses. So in this problem, there is the ends are fixed, that's why definitely the temperature stresses are developed. So for finding out the temperature stresses, we have the formula already. Sigma is equal to E alpha T. So this formula is already derived in the previous lecture. So E, modulus of elasticity, put that value. Alpha is the coefficient of thermal expansion and T is the temperature. For that, the expansion 210 into 10 raised to 3 modulus of elasticity, all these values are put here. So finally, after solving this problem, so we'll get, after simplification, this expression will get the value of sigma. This sigma is nothing but the temperature stress. So this is the temperature stress is developed for this particular aluminium alloy bar, which is 100.8 Newton per mm square. So very simple problem. Only this formula is required to remember for this. By using this, we will easily finding out the temperature stress. We'll take second problem. A steel rod 2 meter long is at 30 degree Celsius. The temperature of this rod is increased to 150 degree Celsius. Find the free expansion of the rod. Temperature stress produced if expansion is prevented, and nature of stress. Third one is stress produced if 2 mm expansion is permitted. Alpha, that is given. Modulus of elasticity is given. Diameter of bar is also given, 16 mm. So given, already written, total length of the bar, increase in temperature. So first initial temperature 150 and final temperature is 30 degree Celsius. So there is an increase in temperature 120 degree. So alpha. So from this, we will first of all calculate the area of cross sectional area of steel rod. So we have the formula pi by 4 into d square. So put the value of d, 16, because diameter of the bar is given, 16 mm. So put that value and finding out the cross-sectional area. Let us start first. Firstly, they ask free expansion of the rod. So if it is a bar is allowed to free expansion with the temperature, at that time there is a expansion, or there is a change in the length of the bar, can be calculated by using this formula. Basic formula, delta L is equal to alpha T L. So put the value of alpha, coefficient of thermal expansion, temperature at which the bar is expanded, and I multiply by length of the bar. So delta L, finally after calculation, so we'll get that delta L, that is a change in the length or change in the expansion of the bar, is taken place 2.88 mm. This is the our first requirement, first finding. Second is the temperature stress produce if expansion is prevented. Whenever there is a prevention of expansion by providing the support at the ends, at that time definitely there is a producing of the temperature stresses. So now temperature stresses for finding, we have the formula. Temperature stress is equal to E alpha T. E is the modulus of elasticity, alpha is the thermal expansion, and T is the temperature. Right. So putting the value, we have all these value, E value, alpha value, and T value. Put all these value here in this formula. So you will get that stress value, 288 Newton per mm square. Though that forces at the support are applied are of compressive nature, that's why. So this particular nature, it is also a compression. Though that expansion is a contract, that's why. So that's why there is a temperature stresses are produced, the compressive type of nature. So 288 Newton per mm square. After that, stress produced if 2 mm expansion is permitted. If the stress is produced if 2 mm expansion is permitted. So at that time, this is the formula for free expansion. If this expansion is already given 2 mm, so they have asked about that, how much temperature is required for the expansion of 2 mm. So putting that value, delta L is equal to alpha TL. So alpha is known, T is unknown. Total length of the bar is 2000 mm, delta L 2 mm. So by calculation, you will get the value of T, that is 83.33 degrees Celsius. That expansion is produced 2 mm. So after getting this, we will again find the temperature stresses develop. So temperature stress, putting again the value and the temperature, we will get the value of temperature stress. So E modulus of elasticity, alpha is known and T is already calculated above. So put all these value and calculate the temperature stress, which will be 199.992 Newton per mm square or MPa. So third problem, a steel rod 20 mm diameter and 5 meter long is connected to two pipes, one at each end, at a temperature of 130 degrees Celsius. Find the pull exerted when temperature falls to 40 degree. First they ask if end do not yield. Second, if ends yield by 1.10 mm. So in this problem, elasticity is given, modulus of elasticity, thermal expansion is also given, and right. So this okay. So given diameter of the bar is given, length of the bar is given 5000, and decrease in the temperature from 130 degrees Celsius to temperature is falling down to 40 degrees Celsius. So total decrease in the temperature is 130 minus 40. So that is a 90 degrees Celsius is the falling in the temperature. Delta, that is the yielding, it is takes place at the support is 1.10 mm. So both of these values known. So first, if end do not yield, if the end do not yield, so there is a free expansion has been taken place. So and so if end do not yield, at that time the stresses develop. First of all, we will calculate. So putting the value of this E alpha and T, so we'll get that temperature stress 216 MPa. So they ask about to finding out the pull exerted when temperature falls. Whenever there is a falling of the temperature, at that time there is a pull is exerted, and pull is means that load. For finding out that load, we have the relation load divided by cross sectional area is equal to temperature stress. So load P1 is equal to, or pull P1 is equal to sigma 1 into A. So sigma 1 is already calculated to 16 multiplied by cross sectional area of this steel rod. So we already knows that pi by 4, 20 mm is the diameter. So put in that value and finding out the pull exerted with that temperature. If end yields by 1.10 mm. Yielding means at the support there is a contraction, it is happened at the support which contracts 1.10 mm. So means delta value is 1.10 mm. So this contraction or this yielding, it is takes place at the support, that delta value is 1.10. So for solution of this, for finding the temperature stress, we have the relation E into alpha TL, that is a total expansion minus this yielding at the support, that value of that expansion at or yield at the support. So this minus delta divided by total length of the bar. So put that modulus of elasticity value, and alpha is known, L is known, T is also known, 90 degree, temperature falling down at 90 degree, and delta, that is the yielding at the support, 1.10, so divided by the original length. So after putting all these value and calculating the stress of temperature stress, so we'll get the temperature stress 172 MPa, that is Newton per mm square. So you remember this value whenever there is a, if a ends are yield by any amount, so you please use this formula for finding out the temperature stresses. Once you found the temperature stress, then they ask about what is, how much pull is exerted, how much pull is exerted for that falling temperature. So again, for the pull, or that suppose pull is P2, so that pulling force, for finding out, we have the relation pulling force divided by cross section area is equal to sigma 2, or P2 is equal to sigma 2 into A. So sigma 2 is the temperature stress is we determine for the yielding amount, and put that sigma 2, that is the temperature stress here, and the cross section area is already known, and after solving this, finding out the pull is exerted for that falling temperature. So that's it. Here we found that if ends do not yield, or for the temperature stresses we found, and pulling also, and if the yielding is taking place at the support, and that amount is yielding is given, at that time you use this formula and finding out the temperature stresses. Thank you very much.